Hi everyone, today we're going to be going through the steps of how to get started in Python on a Mac. However, a near identical process can be followed if you're on Windows. The first thing we are going to do is go to Google and search for Python download. This will bring you to python.org. From here, you can simply download the latest version of Python, which is currently Python 3.8.3 for me. However, if you're looking for an alternative version of Python, such as the legacy Python 2, there is a download drop-down list that you can click through to find what you're looking for. Now that our file is done downloading, we can go to our download files and run the file. There are a couple of confirmation screens that we can just click through. So, once the installer has completed installing Python on your Mac, we can move on to the next step, which is selecting a text editor to use, so that you can actually enter and run your Python codes. We could use something simple like Notepad to run the Python code, however there are free alternatives that will make our lives much easier. These programs are called IDEs, which stands for an Integrated Development Environment. These allow us to easily troubleshoot pieces of our future code, making our lives much easier. There are numerous great Python IDEs, however the most common one I've found is PyCharm. PyCharm looks great and is relatively easy to learn, so let's go back to Google and download PyCharm. When we get to the PyCharm download section, we can see that there are two options. For the vast majority of individuals, the free and open source community PyCharm is all that we need, so let's download that. Once that is done downloading, we can run the .dmg file that we downloaded and drag that over to our applications folder. Now that we have the latest version of Python and PyCharm installed, let's open up PyCharm and quickly take a look. So we can see once we open PyCharm, it will prompt us to start a new project. So let's do that, and of course you can name the project whatever you please. So on the left, you can see the folder that we just created. On this folder, we can right-click and select New, then Python File. In future videos, we'll get into the Python programming language, but for now, just to ensure that everything is working correctly, let's print test to the console. We can do this by typing all lowercase print bracket quotation mark test quotation mark and bracket, and at the bottom, once we click run, we can see that the test was properly printed to the console, so we know everything is working correctly. Thank you guys for checking out the video. If you enjoyed, please like and subscribe to support the channel. However, if you have any comments, questions, or concerns about the information I provided in this video, leave a comment down below and I will do my best to address your concerns.